I'm at the top of the stairs that go down to the riverbank, but I wanted to show you just how that power thing worked. That is the back of the mill over there, and the water came in at the left, and it's still coming in the left today. In the 19th century, they directed it down into the basement of the mill to turn the turbine and run the pipes. Now they have a slightly different arrangement here, and the water goes down to its turbine and creates hydroelectric power. And then it pours out after it has turned those turbines and soars down and rejoins below the fall. Okay, that's the gorge coming up to the falls again. I'm here at the tail race underneath the power plant by Cohoes Falls. I hope you can hear me above the sound of roaring water and electric motors humming. That is the sound of alternative energy in action. They've diverted the Mohawk River upstream, channeled it down where it runs through some turbines, and it comes out and that turns back to the Mohawk River here, right here. This is the fishing spot in this trace, but a few wild birds are fishing right now. Take another look at the power plant. This, I believe, was put together in the early 20th century. And this, like that structure there, when Brookfield took it over later in the century, they added things here. That is what you hear behind me. It's generating the electricity that is flowing through those lines right now. I read somewhere it was like 60,000 houses they could supply. It's pretty good stuff. There's the water again. People have arrived. Here's the river. Heading on down towards the Mohawk, which is that, or towards the Hudson, which is that.